learned what is the trapezium. A pair of opposite side is parallel, it is called a trapezium. Both pairs are parallel, it is called a parallelogram. In a parallelogram, one angle 90, it is a rectangle. In a rectangle, all the sides are equal, it is square. In a parallelogram, all the sides are equal, rhombus. Okay. Which quadrilaterals diagonals equal? Which quadrilaterals diagonals equal? Square and rectangle. Correct or not? Square and rectangle. Which quadrilaterals each angle 90 degree? Each angle 90 degree. Which quadrilateral each angle 90 degree? Rectangle and square. Rectangle and square. Okay. Rectangle and square. And what are the properties of a parallelogram? What are the properties of a parallelogram? One. What are the properties of a parallelogram? Tell me fast. One, opposite sides are parallel. Two, opposite sides are equal. Three, opposite angles are equal. Four, diagonal bisect each other. Correct or not? Five, a diagonal divides into two congruent triangles. A diagonal divides into two congruent triangles. Okay, next. When a quadrilateral become a parallelogram? When a quadrilateral become a parallelogram? If opposite sides are equal, it is a parallelogram. If opposite sides are parallel, it is a parallelogram. Opposite angles are equal, it is a parallelogram. Diagonal bisect each other, it is a parallelogram. Last one. A pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. Correct? A pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. It is called a parallelogram. Clear now? Okay, now. So just go to the reader first. Okay, go to page 142. Page 142, example 2 and 3. Example 2, 3, 4. Example 2, 3, 4, 5. Example 2, 3, 4, 5. Not down. Example 2, 3, 4, 5. Then page 146, 3, 4, 5. Hey, any question drop, tell me. DPS, any question drop, tell me now. 8.1, anything drop? 8.1, question number 5. Okay, so I don't need to work out it. So 3 and 4. Okay, 3 and 4. 3 and 4 only, okay? 8.1, 3 and 4. Page 141, next. Page 141, 9, 10, 9, 10, 12, 9, 10, 12, 9, 10, 12. Okay. Then you learn one of the important theorem, midpoint theorem. Okay. The line segment passing through the midpoint of two sides of a triangle is parallel to third side and equal to half of it. Proof not done. Correct or no? Proof not done. Right? No DPS, no proof. Okay. And converse of midpoint theorem. The line segment passing through the midpoint of one side, parallel to second side, it will bisect the third side. Okay. So then 8.2, which questions drop? I think 6 and 7 drop. 8.2, which question drop? 6 and 7. Okay. Now that means you have to do 2, 1, 2, 3, and 5. 1, 2, 3, and 5. So very simple. Look at here. Listen. Hello. Before starting, I'll just go through the chapter. Listen. You should learn what is a trapezium. In a quadrilateral, one pair of opposite side is parallel. It is called a trapezium. In a trapezium, two sides are equal, it is called an isosceles trapezium. Okay, in a quadrilateral, opposite sides are parallel, it is called a parallelogram. In a parallelogram, adjacent sides are equal, it is rhombus. In a parallelogram, each angle 90 degree, it is rectangle. In a rectangle, all sides are equal, it is called square. Okay. Then kite, what? Kite, adjacent sides are equal, but opposite sides are not equal. Correct or no? Then properties of parallelogram. One, opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are parallel. Diagonal bisect each other. A pair diagonal divides into congruent triangles. Okay. Then when a quadrilateral become parallelogram. One, opposite sides are equal. It is a parallelogram. Opposite sides are parallel. It is a parallelogram. Diagonal bisect each other. It is a parallelogram. Opposite angles are equal. It is a parallelogram. Last one, important thing, a pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. Okay. Then in which quadrilaterals diagonals equal? Square and rectangle. In which quadrilaterals diagonals perpendicularly bisect each other? Which one? In which quadrilaterals diagonals perpendicularly bisect each other? Rhombus and square. Rhombus and square. Hello. Rhombus, akshara. Rhombus and square. In which quadrilateral diagonals, listen, in which quadrilateral diagonals perpendicular bisect each other? Rhombus and okay. Okay, diagonal equal, diagonal equal square and rectangle. Diagonal perpendicular bisect each other, square and rhombus. Okay, now we are going to listen. We can take half an hour maximum. You can take time till 7:15. Till 7:15, read a questions. Then I'll go to extra questions. Okay. So no need 7:15. Okay, half an hour. Okay. Okay. Example. Listen. Once again, late comments. Example 2, page 142. Example 2. Example 3. Example 4. Example 5. Okay. 8.1, 3 and 4. Then 9, 10, 12. Okay. Then example 7, example 8. Example 7 and example 8. Then 8.2, 1, 2, 3 and 5. 1, 2, 3 and 5. Okay. 7, maximum 7:15. You have to finish it. 7:15, I'll start extra questions. So speed up now. Okay, do fast. Okay. 7:15, everyone should finish this reader. Then start. I'll do the extra questions. Speed up now. Okay. In case not getting, tell me, Adil. And Siddha, if not getting, tell. Are you getting or not? This all. Don't just copy from the reader, okay? Thank you. Okay, hello, getting? Speed up, 7:15 I have to start. And sit up, getting or not? Okay, question number 12 8.1. Okay. Twelfth question. Look at here. This question, look. Twelfth question. Where is the question? Okay, Murdula, look at here. Look. ABCD is a trapezium. Look at here. Hello. ABCD is a trapezium in which AB parallel CD. Okay. A, B, C, D is a trapezium in which this one equal to this parallel, this equal to this one. What do you show? Angle A equal to angle B, C equal to D. Okay, first show these two. Look, through C, draw a line parallel here, like this. E here. What happened? Through Mrudula, those who have doubt, question number 12, listen here. Through C, draw a line parallel to DA, which intersect at E when AB extended. Now, AE parallel to DC, given. DA parallel to CE by construction. Therefore, AECD is a parallelogram. Hence, AD equal to EC, number one. And AD equal to BC, given, number two. That means EC equal to BC. This equal to this one. Hence, this angle, X, is also X. Okay. Now, this is X means this also X, alternate angles. Right? Okay. This is X, this also X. In parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. Okay. Now, angle A plus angle D, 180. So this is 180 minus X. This also 180 minus X. So now finished, no? Look, angle A equal to angle B, angle C equal to angle D. Finish. Mrudula, clear now? What I did, listen. Once again, I'll tell you. Look, through C, draw a line parallel to DA, which intersect at E when AB extended. Okay. After that, proof. AE parallel to DC, given. AD parallel to EC by construction. Therefore, AECD is a parallelogram. Bracket, opposite sides are parallel. Hence, AD equal to EC. Opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. AD equal to BC, given. Number two, from 192 we get EC equal to BC. Hence, angle CBE equal to angle E. Angles opposite equal sides are equal. Let X. Okay. Angle ABC plus angle EBC, 180 minus 180. So this is 180 minus X. Here this is X, this also X, alternate angles. Okay. Angle E plus angle D, X. In parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. Then, angle A plus D, 180, co-interior angles. So this is 180 minus X. Therefore, we got A equal to B and C equal to D. Okay. Remaining part, Mrudula, you can try third and fourth. You draw separate triangle, separate figure. Look. A, B, C, D. Which triangle? Triangle ABC. And BAD. Okay. In triangle ABC and BAD, AB equal to BA. AB equal to BA, common. Angle B equal to angle A, proved. BC equal to AD, given. Therefore, these triangles are confirmed by SIS. Side, angle, side. Side, angle, side. Fourth what? CPCT. Clear now? Okay. Speed up. We have 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, I'll start extra questions. Okay, speed up. Okay, so finish public question balance. Okay, finish or not? Anyone finish? Okay, how many question balance, Akshaya? So I'll give 15 minutes more, okay? So, okay, now try to finish it before 7:30. Till 7:30 you can do it, okay. 7:30, okay. Without reader, I cannot go to the extra questions. Amen. You getting or not?
Mohit.
Okay, so now look at here. Oh, we have 5 minutes more. Okay, finish it fast. Okay, now remaining question, you can finish it. Okay, listen, it's a reader question only. Write the question. ABC is a triangle, right? Hello, write the questions. ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. Right. ABC is a triangle. D is a point on AB. D is a point on AB such that AD equal to 1/4 AB. ABC is a triangle such that D is a point such that AD equal to 1/4 AB. And E is a point. E is a point. E, capital E, is a point. E is a point such that AE equal to 1/4 AC. Prove that DE equal to half BC. DE equal to half BC. Okay. Try now. Question again. ABC is a triangle such that AD equal to 1/4, AD equal to 1/4 AB, AE equal to 1/4 AC. Prove that DE equal to 1/4 BC. Prove that DE equal to 1/4 BC. AD equal to 1/4 BC. No, AB. No, no, no. Who said AB equal to AC? Who said? Don't say. Don't add extra data. Okay. Given is what? AD equal to 1/4 AB. AE equal to 1/4 AC. Show that DE equal to 1/4 BC. Okay, look at here. Look, this is a star question. Listen, there is a concession. Mark the midpoint of AB and AC. P and Q are the midpoints. Okay, right. Concession. Right, concession. Mark the midpoint of AB and AC, P and Q respectively. Mark the midpoint of AB, P, and midpoint of AC, Q, and join PQ. Okay. Now look at here. Hello, listen. AP, don't write. AP equal to half AB by conception. AD equal to 1/4 AB given. Then we need, now look at here, AP minus AD, how much? half AB minus quarter AB. That means DP. DP equal to quarter AB. Agree or not? This part clear or not? Look at here. AP is half of AB. AD is quarter AB. Therefore, DP is quarter AB. Because half minus quarter. Half dinar minus quarter dinar means what? Quarter dinar, like that. Any doubt this one? Adil, you clear that this part? Adil, and sit up. Hello. This clear or not? AP equal to half of AB by construction. AD is quarter AB given. Therefore, DP equal to quarter AB. Okay. Hence, D is the midpoint of AP. Right. Hence, D is the midpoint of AP. Similarly, E is the midpoint of AQ. Similarly, E is the midpoint of AQ. Okay, writing, you know? Hello, everyone writing or not? Okay, once again, what do you wrote? Listen, that's not writing light like this. AD equal to quarter AB. AP equal to half AB by construction. Then, so therefore, DP equal to quarter AB. Hence, D is the midpoint of AP. Similarly, E is the midpoint of AQ. Okay, now listen here. Hello, listen. Look at the triangle. In triangle APQ, D and E are the midpoints. In triangle APQ, D is the midpoint of AP, E is the midpoint of AQ. Therefore, DE equal to half of PQ, right? By midpoint theorem. After that, in triangle ABC, P and Q are the midpoints. Then PQ equal to half of PQ. PQ equal to half of BC equal to. BC equal to half of PQ. BC equal to half of PQ. Listen. PQ equal to half of BC. Paste here. DE equal to half into PQ again, half BC. That means 1 by 4 BC. Clear now? So we got DE equal to half of BC. Are you okay or not? Is it okay? Clear now? If not getting, tell me. This is a very important question. Okay. We did before. Okay. Okay. Okay, so next question. Finish. Right. In triangle ABC, this is a star question. In triangle ABC, AD is a median. AD is a median. In triangle ABC, AD is a median through A. AD is a median through A. And E is the midpoint of AD. E is the midpoint of AD. BE produced meet AC in F. Prove that AF equal to 1/3 AC. Prove that AF equal to 1 by 3 AC. Question again. In triangle ABC, AD is a median through A. AD is a median through A. And E is the midpoint of AD. BE produced meet AC in F. Prove that AF equal to 1/3 AC. Okay. DPS, which chapter going on now? Hello? Construction, okay. That means everything finished, only construction only, right? Okay. Okay. So try this one. Question is what? In triangle ABC, AD is the median. AD is the median through A. E is the midpoint of AD. BE produced meet AC in F. Prove that AF equal to 1/3 AC. Okay. Okay. Look. In triangle ABC, AD is a median. E is the midpoint of AD. BE produced F. Show that AF equal to 1/3 AC. Understand the figure now? Akshaya. Thank you. Okay. Okay, so we got this one. Anybody got? Join a construction, yes. Okay, so now look at here. To D, draw a line parallel to G here. Look. Through D, draw a line parallel to BF. Now look at here. In triangle ADG, look at here. In triangle ADG is the midpoint. EF parallel to DG. By converse of midpoint theorem, F is the midpoint. So AF equal to FG. Call it number one. After that, in triangle BFC, D is the midpoint. DG parallel to BF. G is the midpoint. FG equal to GC. Number two. Therefore, AF equal to FG equal to GC. Hence, AF equal to 1 by 3 AC. Okay. Finish. It's clear now. Everybody okay? This is one of the star question. Okay. So make sure. Adil, clear or not? Okay. I'll wait. Murdula, finish it fast. Thank you. Okay, finish. Mridula, finish or not? Okay. Okay, listen here. A quadrilateral, the midpoint of the sides of a quadrilaterals, a quadrilateral formed by joining the midpoint of the sides of a quadrilateral is parallelogram, right? What? The quadrilateral form by joining the midpoints of the sides of a quadrilateral is quadrilateral. Okay. In case of the figure form by joining the midpoint of the sides of a rectangle is what? Rhombus, right? Correct or no? What about rhombus? The figure form by joining the midpoint of the rhombus is what? Rectangle. Okay. Square is what? The figure form by joining the midpoint of the sides of a square is a square. You know how to prove it. That's a very important thing. Okay. Listen here. Quadrilateral parallelogram. Okay. What about parallelogram? Parallelogram, nothing, right? Parallelogram is a parallelogram only. Okay. Rectangle, rhombus. Rhombus, rectangle, right? Square, square. Okay. Now write the question. D, E, F are respectively the midpoint of the sides. D, E, F. Okay, D, E, F are respectively the midpoint of the sides BC, CA, AB of an equilateral triangle ABC. D, D, E, F are respectively the midpoint of the sides BC, CA, and AB of an equilateral triangle ABC. Prove that D, E, F also equilateral triangle. Prove that D, E, F also equilateral triangle. Listen, D, D, E, and F are respectively the midpoint of the sides BC, CA, AB of an equilateral triangle ABC. Prove that DEF also equilateral triangle. DEF also equilateral triangle. Can you try? Okay. Look at here. Look. D, E, F. Listen here. D, A, B, C. D, E, F. D, E, F. Okay. Look at here. D is the midpoint. E is the midpoint. DE equal to half of AB. EF half of BC. DF half of AC. Number one, number two, number three. One more thing. AB equal to BC equal to AC. Therefore, DEF also. Therefore, Okay, finish. Next question. Are you okay? Okay. Right. ABCD is a parallelogram. In ABCD is a parallelogram, angle DAB 60 degree, angle DAB 60 degree, angle DAB 60 degree. Okay. If the bisectors AP and BP, if the bisectors AP and BP of angle A and B respectively, meet at P on CD. Prove that P is the midpoint of CD. Okay, listen here. ABCD is a parallelogram. Look. ABCD is a parallelogram. Angle DAB 60. DAB 60. Okay. If the bisectors AP and BP. Okay, AP and BP intersect at P. Show that P is the midpoint of CD. Okay, try this one. Can you try? In try, ABCD is a parallelogram. Angle DAB 60 degree. AP and BP are bisectors. Show that P is the midpoint. Okay, try now. Okay, try now first. Anybody got? Achaya, you got? Marsuk, you got the question? Marsuk. Hello. Okay, I'll wait. Okay, anybody got? Hello, look at here. If not getting, listen here. Look, this one 30, right? This also 30. If this 30, here also 30. Okay, now look at here. In triangle ADB, 30, 30. Therefore, AD equal to DP, number one. Okay. Listen here once again, angle DAB 60, AP the bisector, 30, 30. This 30, this also 30. 30 opposite AD. This is DP, number one. This one is 120, because 60 here, 120 here. So 60, 60, 60. So that means BC equal to PC, number two. From 190, but AD equal to BC. AD equal to BC, that means DP equal to PC. Okay, copy first. Okay, you got like this. Shoaib, you got? What's the name? Ansita, finish or not? Okay, so next question. Right. ABCD is a parallelogram. Right. ABCD is a parallelogram. Next one. ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram and line segment AX, AX and CY, AX and CY bisect the angle A and C, bisect the angle C and C, A and C. Prove that AX parallel to CY. Prove that AX parallel to CY. Prove that AX parallel to CY. Okay, try now. Okay, finish. What do you got? Look at here. Here one, this is, look at here. Hello. Look. Okay, one equal to two. Why? Wait. Angle A equal to angle C. Correct or not? Angle A equal to angle C. Then angle A by 2 equal to angle C by 2. That is 1 equal to angle 2. Number 1. 2 equal to 3. angle 2 equal to angle 3. Number 2, alternate angles. That means angle 1 equal to angle 3. Angle 1 equal to angle 3. 1 equal to 3. 1 and 3 are, 1 and 3 are corresponding angles. 1 and 3 are corresponding angles. Therefore, AX parallel to CY. AX parallel to CY. Okay. Right now. Right? I'll give the note. Angle A equal to angle C. Angle A equal to angle A equal to angle C. In bracket, right? In parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. Opposite angles are equal. In parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. Then, angle A by 2 equal to angle C by 2. Angle A by 2 equal to angle C by 2. Angle A by 2 equal to angle C by 2. That is, angle 1 equal to angle 2. Angle 1 equal to angle 2. In bracket, right? AX and CY. AX and CY are the bisectors of angle A and angle C. AX and CY are the bisectors of angle A and C. Then, angle 2 equal to angle 3. Alternate angles. Angle 2 equal to angle 3, alternate angles. Number 2. From 1 and 2, we get angle 1 equal to angle 3. Angle 1 equal to angle 3. Then, since the alternate angles are equal, AX parallel to CY. AX parallel to CY. Okay. AX parallel to C. Clear now? Is it okay? Okay, this is enough today. Okay, next class based on the schedule, you prepare it. Okay.